Sagen Sie jetzt mal bitte, Anarchie.
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 Ob geschichtlich oder brandaktuell.
Mit Berichten und Interviews, mit Beiträgen und Collagen
beleuchtet das anarchistische Radio Berlin das Phänomen des Anarchismus.
Viva Anarchia!
As part of a journey through Eastern Europe, a member of the Anarchist Radio Berlin had the opportunity of talking to a comrade of the Anarchist Federation in Poznan, in Poland, in the Rozbrat squad. In the following interview, we talk about the historical development of the squad that celebrated its 21st anniversary on the weekend of September 18 and 19, and also about current struggles of FA Poznan, especially the worker struggle of the Amazon workers in Germany and Poznan. Additionally, we were talking about a transnational meeting concerning the topic of a European-wide social strike. The meeting will take place from the 2nd to the 4th of October 2015 in Poznan. Some more interviews with anarchist organizations and anarchist projects will follow soon as part of our new series on anarchism and social struggles in Eastern Europe. Check out our blog at aradio.blogspot.de.
Hello, Chris. I'm sitting here with Chris in Rozbrat. Could you tell us a little bit about Rozbrat? Which kind of project is it? Since when does it exist?
Okay, so it's 21 years old and it's complex of post-industrial warehouses close to the center of the city. So at the beginning it was place only for live, for a few people connected with DIY anti-fascist scene. But later the next buildings were renovated, and let's say second part of development of this squad was related to the DIY subculture. So it became place with some counterculture activities, mainly concerts, and later the place started to be more connected with some social activity related to the Polish anarchist movement and initiatives developed by this movement. So let's say the place have this three basic dimensions in terms of existing, like the place for a living, for a people, the place of some subculture center, and the place of some anarchist social activity related to some class politics, let's say.
Okay, so and are you linked with other projects in Poznan or maybe Poland, or are you doing your own thing here?
I mean, from this place goes out many different initiatives which are now developing outside of this place. Like, for example, in 2004 we established a workers union. It's called Workers Initiative. It started as informal group, but in 2004, after let's say 4 years of informal activity, became formal union. Let's say we have tenant association, which started formally about 3 years ago. We have one bookshop in the center of the city, and we have next squad, which is finishing in this month. The squad is in the old market, established by some younger people from our group, from our milieu. And after 3 years of activity, they make some deal with the owner and they are going out, let's say, in a peace manner. Mm-hmm. So on the level of our city, let's say something more is the publishing house, which is running more than 10 years, and distribution of some, let's say, critical literature and political literature. And on the level of the country, we are connected with the Anarchist Federation, which basically as kind of network of the section now is not active in Poland at all. But we are still section of Anarchist Federation. As a group from Poznan, we are this section almost 20 years. Maybe this is the tradition why we still use this name, even the organization is not so active now. Then we are running Anarchist Black Cross, and this is as well kind of network around the Poland of support of the political activists which have sometimes problems with law. And basically we have a lot of informal connections with some squads, with some workers' unions, with tenants' associations, with different political groups, with some publishings.
So you said the Polish Federation does not working, but are you connected with international groups, maybe over the International Workers' Association or the International Federation of Anarchists?
No, the Anarchist Federation started at the end of the 80s, and the beginning of anarchist movement in Poland is just like beginning of 80s, and it was just like part of the opposition against communist regime. Later, at the end of 80s, there was idea of establishing the network, which became called Anarchist Federation, and in the 90s became quite active network of different groups from the city all over the Poland, but let's say last 10 years it's more decline of the activity on the level of Anarchist Federation. There's not much sections, not much going on. There was some attempt to join to this Anarchist Federation International. It was maybe around 2002. We visited some meeting of this international, but we decided that this is not useful for us.
Okay.
This international. So let's say we doesn't have much contact with them. On the other hand, man, I'm not in this because there are some connection between the syndicalist unions. Mm-hmm. And this really, I don't know. I'm doing some stuff on the basic of the. So I cannot say much about this international connection because I'm not so formal in terms of unions.
Mm-hmm.
I'm more on the, let's say, level of the process of production and people inside of the places of work.
You know? Yeah.
I'm not dealing with this international.
Could you tell us a little bit about current fights you are involved in? Maybe with FA Poznan?
Yeah, from FA Poznan, just develop the different activities based on the different groups, like for example, Workers' Initiative. So Workers' Initiative has some kind of syndicalist, autonomist union, have, let's say, about 1,000 people now, 1,000 workers inside of different branches. So in our city, the commission of the unions, of the union are in the Amazon warehouse, which is running last year, which was open 1 year ago. Then we have crane operators in our city. Then we have nurseries, about 200 of them in this section. Then we have workers of the old heavy industrial factory, which now producing the engines to the ships. Then we have commission in the theater in the center of the city. And then we have commission of, let's say, cultural workers and artists, yeah, which are working on very precarious conditions in Poland. So this is only our city, and sometimes looks like that in different cities. Like if you go, for example, if you go to Warsaw, they have few new commissions. And in other small cities we have as well just like one or two commissions. Then in our city we have in Poznan, we have tenant association, which basically fighting with the illegal evictions, fighting for the building of the social housing, and basically fighting against the local authorities, which worse the conditions of the tenants, explaining this on the level of this austerity politics. The budget of the city is quite small now. It's under the pressure of debt, so the local authorities need to pay lot of the money every year for the banks to repay the loans. One way of making the money by the local authorities is just making higher the rents of the community houses, or how you call it, social houses. So this is one of the big problem in the city. So we are dealing with this issue last 4 years. What else? I mean, basic, just like, for example, last 4 years we have some kind of wave of nationalism in Poland. So there is some counter activities against this nationalist tendency in our city, which is not so strong compared other cities. But still, there are some kind of actions against them. And of course, the publishing house is kind of let's say, involving a lot of energy, lot of time, and many people are doing quite professional job related to the preparation of the publishing, typesetting, editing. So we are publishing books in a publishing house, and we are help to publish magazines which are run by our friends. But for example, we provide this formal structure as a publisher. So I don't remember the question. What was all about our activities?
Yes, activities.
Well, and of course, basic, you know, daily stuff like concerts, on the squad, some I don't know, some.
Maybe you could tell also about some current struggles, like the struggle with Amazon workers in Germany.
Yeah. I can see something more about Amazon, just like this. Like about 1 year ago, the Amazon opened warehouse under our city, which is on the border of the city, let's say. Some people from our group just start to work in this place. And after a few months, they established the section of the union. Now it's probably, I don't know, a few hundred, 200 workers in place of work. In the spring in this year, the workers from Poznan, Amazon, they heard about the strikes in the Germany. So in one day, when the strike was going on in the Germany, they make slowdown. It was unofficial action, but the management tried to make some pressure on the workers. So it was kind of, let's say, local affair in the warehouse.
Mm-hmm.
We get some attention of the media. Now the connections between Poznan, Amazon workers, and Amazon warehouses in Berlin and other German cities are developing. In last weekend we had an international meeting between Polish and German workers. We are planning some common activities before the Christmas, when is the peak time, when the Amazon is under the pressure of the high rate of orders, and they try to realize the orders as fast as possible. This is the best time to do some kind of activity. Workers at that time have the biggest power in relation to the managers. So this is ongoing activity of the section of the union. This is kind of, let's say, on the level of the process of production. In terms of tenant struggles, basically there's a lot of illegal evictions in our city, the private owners. I can explain one mechanism how it works. The situation on the housing market looks like, if you buy the house with tenants, they have right to get new flat if you want to evict them. So of course, if you're buying the house, then the house with the tenants is quite cheap compared to the house without tenant, compared to the empty house with, let's say, 20 flats inside. But now the owners or the businessmen or capitalists, they just buy houses with the tenants inside, and they do some illegal activities to kick them out without providing next flats for them. For example, they are cutting water or electricity, or they are renting some semi-mafia guys which now became called cleaners, and they should clean the old building from the tenants. So they try to treat the tenants. And basically, if tenants are weak, if they are older people, if they are afraid, they run away from the house without any new flat. Yeah? They organize they need to organize flat by your own. But basically, in terms of law, the owner, if want to kick them out or want to make big renovation, basic renovation of the house, need to provide it. But yeah, just like I said, it's more profitable to, for example, rent some cleaner, semi-mafia guy who will treat the tenants, and they, let's say, will run away without any problems. Yeah? So many times that kind of tenants from cleaning houses, cleaning by these cleaners, coming to us and asking for help, and sometimes we can run quite good resistance against this what are doing owners. Let's say 2 years ago, the tenants with us blockade the house, so the cleaners and the owners couldn't go inside of the house, and they stay about 1 year longer in the house. Now we have the same situation with next house. They didn't blockade it, but the owner act as a cleaner. But at the end, after kind of resistance of the tenants and few actions, which the whole process of this defense take about 5 months, now the situation looks like the owner make a proposition to the local authorities that he can pay for a renovation of the communal flats, in which this tenants from his house could start to live. We'll see what will happen. But basically this issue wasn't on the public agenda, let's say 4 years ago, but now it is. Now local authorities decided, the new mayor of the city decided to build 4,000 new communal flats. The previous mayor was governing of the city last 16 years. In last 5 years, maybe he built about 100, 200 flats. So now, let's say, it's a kind of new opening. We will see what will happen.
Yeah.
But
sounds great.
Yeah, but we see this kind of influence of our longer term activity on this what's going on in the city, on this how the budget is creating. And the same situation with the nursery. The women joined to the union about 3 years ago. They are employed by the local authorities. And every year now, before they introduce the new budget, we are protesting and we are putting on the public agenda the question of the wages of the nursery. Mm-hmm. And every year before the budget, they want some improvement of the wages. So this is as well ongoing, let's say, struggle for the better wages. And last 3 years, they get about 20-30% rise of the wages in last 3 years.
We were talking about the strike of the immigrants in Germany. It sounds like some kind of transnational work would be useful. And I also read the call for a transnational meeting, which will take place in Poznan at the beginning of October. Maybe you could tell us a little bit about this meeting.
That's the initiative run by groups from different countries all over Europe, from UK, Italy, Germany, Poland, France. This initiative started around Blockupy and emerged from the debate, the political debate related to the organization in places of work, debate around work as such, debate about changing composition of the working class, and debate about the social strike. So these all debates run by these groups last years reached some level of, I don't know, conclusion or organization, which took idea of connecting into on the international level of some kind of efforts to bring the issue of organization organizing on the level of process of production inside of the social movements, or return back this issue to the agenda of social movements. So as well, this is kind of reaction on the, let's say, culturalist approach or to the social activity or approach which is related more to the, let's say, citizen disobedience, which is somehow out of the places of work, out of the process of production. This is effort to return to the issues related to the places of work and direct conflict between labor and capital. So that's the probably basic background of this meeting. If we look more particularly, probably there are particular issues related with the, let's say, neoliberal characteristic of the production, which is related to the long production chains and the industrialization in the Western countries, and industrialization or new industrialization in the post-socialist country, and new industrialization in, let's say, China or Far East countries. So probably this is the one issue. Next issue is general precarization of the condition of labor, unstable wages and unstable condition of work. The third issue could be the ways of organizing and the ways of developing of some organization on the base of place of work internationally. So basically the meeting will be some kind of base for developing of the debate about the class struggle in place of work, and some that's the one thing. And the second thing, why is this meeting, is probably kind of effort to do some common activities between workers and some political activities which are living in different countries in Europe. basically to develop class politics.
This meeting will take place from 2nd to 4th October in Poznan, and maybe you would like to start another call to all the comrades which are listening to A Radio to come to this meeting.
Well, I mean, the meeting will be just like we'll connect the activists, probably a few academics and workers. Mm-hmm. It will be in English, basically. Thursday it will be general debate or general, let's say, panel discussion. Mm-hmm. About the different conditions of the relation between labor and capital in different countries of Europe. And the next 2 days mainly will be some smaller meetings about particular issues, as social strike, as logistic issue, as question related to the migration and labor, question related to the some ways of organizing. So yeah, basically everything will be in English. The people who are interested in the class politics are welcome, in terms of exchange of experience and in terms of developing some debate about the issues related to the place of work.
Okay, yeah. Thank you, Chris, yeah, for the interview.
Easy.
Is there anything special you would like to add?
No.
Okay, then we will have a great weekend. We will celebrate the 21st anniversary of Rozbrat.
Yes, mass destruction.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.